What's up, YouTube? Capital G here. Got a couple of Dark Lord duels for you guys to check out. We all know that Dark Lords just recently got a Link monster, which is just crazy because the lore behind this thing is all over the place. You guys know Witch's Strike and Savage Strike. We thought that she was going to try to kill Gon, but now we got this new card and the Condemned Maiden is now a Dark Lord. I don't know what is going on with the story. Some people think that she actually killed Gon. I do not believe that at all. Yu-Gi-Oh! Has had a solemn card in every single era. I think that the story is going to continue after that, although I did predict she was going to die, so I guess I was wrong. Who the heck am I to talk? But until we get our new Solemn card, we won't really know. I didn't think that this card was all that good. That's why I didn't cover it. But with Morningstar, it's actually pretty damn nice, and it's really cool because it allows Dark Lords to get Morningstar on the field consistently, and it also has a built-in Rota, plus it gives them life points, so that's something, like, all those things they kind of do want in a card. I just didn't know if they were going to be able to drop the card consistently enough, but Dark Lords still have really good strong turn ones, specifically because of Ixtab and the amount of draw cards that they have. I've never thought that Ash Blossom definitively stops Dark Lords, because they do have trade-in and a whole bunch of other things. I thought that Droll and Lockbird could definitively stop them, but definitely not Ash Blossom. I like the, you know, Ash Blossom, the Ixtab, if they use that. Now, I don't know if you guys noticed this, I am not a fan of Pot of Desires in Lunalights anymore. I don't feel like they need it, but honestly, this is just a bad matchup for Lunalights. A lot of the high Lunalight fusion monsters are immune to targeting, but Dark Lord, their trap cards don't really target, so it's like the best protection you have for double L's is just going out the window. You saw right there him go into the Dark Lord Link monster, and instead of using monsters on the field to tribute, he actually banished cards in his graveyard. That means he's able to summon Morningstar. Morningstar will then drop out a couple of big monsters, and at this point, there's not much you can't do. He's going to gain some light points, and he should be able to OTK his opponent. If your opponent does have monsters on the field, you can either just pop those monsters, or even better, just take those monsters, because if you don't happen to kill your opponent, not only are you using their monsters as your offense, but you can also, you know, convert those monsters into Link materials as well to make sure your opponent is just not going to get them back. So second duel is another run back against Lunalights. My boy Atenza hitting me up with these duels. He knew that these duels were going to trigger me, because he knows that, like, he's a really big Dark Lord fan, and he knows I love Lunalights so much, and we used to always go back and forth with our duels on my Twitch stream, and it'd be like Ultra Geist versus Dark Lords, and you know, I used to start smashing them when I got Multifaker, but now I don't know, it might not be as easy as it was before. Double L's are going second. I don't think you get much value out of Lunalight Fusion in this matchup, because this the Dark Lord deck doesn't go into its extra deck like turn one. There's no point. There's no point of them really summoning the Link monster until they need to, unless you're running like Christie or something like that. But he is going to just take Saber Dancer, because, you know, all the monsters that I've said, all the double L high level monsters are all just kind of countered by this deck. The fact that there's no targeting, and now he gets to summon a couple more big monsters. Morningstar was a card that I didn't think was that good, because you can't summon it, but now you can just tribute summon it, using Condemned Dark Lord, as your graveyard basically allows you to, you know, use those as tribute materials. Then you just start taking your opponent's monsters. You see now he is going to go for a Link summon, and you know, these are a couple of duels that the duel just basically ended in a flash. Like, you blinked and you ended up missing these duels. I think Dark Lords have always had a whole bunch of offense. It's just, you know, they haven't been able to consistently get some of the best cards like Morningstar on the board, but now things are changing, and the Link monster, it actually does make them a little more consistent. I always felt like this deck was underrated just because of how much draw you have. Trade in, obviously, Pot of Desires, Dark Lord is Shell is another draw card, so the deck has always had draw power, and when you have this many big beaters, obviously you can OTK pretty easily. So let's pause for one quick second and check out this deck list. Alright, so this is what the deck looks like on paper. You know, it really is amazing to see her transformation. You have her as the Condemned Maiden, where, you know, she was struck down by God, and then she was the Condemned Witch. Obviously, she wasn't happy about that, and I guess she's at peace now that she's a Dark Lord. She's basically like a cast-out angel or something like that. When it looks like, when it comes to this build, you can obviously see this is pretty much as pure as it gets. I mean, I've always thought, like, the best Dark Lords, including Superbia, just run, like, three copies of them. Superbia, not a hard once per turn. This card is, like, super old, if I'm not mistaken. pick. And this was in like the first. I feel like this is a 5Ds card. I know that there's a small Dark Lord that also has the effect that foolishes your Dark Lord monsters into the graveyard. It's a hard once per turn, but it can be activated when it's special summoned. Most Dark Lord builds that I've seen have run three copies of Pot of Desires, just because you can't really afford to brick in this deck, and you kind of need to be able to hit like your Monster Reborns early. This card right here, Dark Lord Contact, like you have to be able to get to it. Interesting to see no Soul Charge. Sometimes Dark Lords will run Soul Charge because it's a very powerful card in general. Anytime that you get Superbia, you are going to be able to get one of your other Dark Lords in the grave. And Soul Charge is just a really good recovery card. Like if you happen to trade in one of your Dark Lords, which is not in here, or if you happen to use Ishell and, what's that called, or Ixtab, by the way? If you happen to use, that's the OCG name. If you happen to use Ishell, and she happens to get ashed or use trade in and gets ashed, like Soul Charge usually just like a really good recovery play. But I mean, I guess there is like Monster Reborn in here. A lot of traps because this is not like a pure OTK. Go first, basically get Superbia and Ishell on the field, maybe one more, and then just kind of like use your trap cards to stall your opponent for one turn. After that, you will have the ability to OTK. Usually Morningstar is more than enough damage with the monsters that it summons to get the job done.